Author Viet Thanh Nguyen received the 2016 Pulitzer Prize for Fiction with his debut novel, The Sympathizer. It's about a Vietnamese man who flees war in his homeland and struggles through a new life in America. He also edited a highly acclaimed nonfiction book, The Displaced Refugee Writers on Refugee Lives. His writings have made Nguyen an authority on the refugee and immigrant experience, especially for Asian Americans. It's something he knows well. Nguyen was only four when he and his family fled from war-torn Vietnam for a new life in the U.S. Today, he shares an original essay recounting memories of that time and what they tell us about America today.
I'm a refugee. Come around here. Come around here.
I'm a refugee and the son of refugees. I grew up in San Jose, California. From my bedroom window, I saw the entrance ramp to the freeway. And I wondered where all those cars were going, and I wanted to go with them. When I look out my window now, almost 40 years later, I see a garden and the tops of towering trees, and I know that this green view wouldn't be possible without my parents. Like many refugees, they were human sacrifices. They risked their lives to flee a war-torn country, Vietnam. And then gave of themselves in this new country so their children wouldn't have to risk their lives or sacrifice themselves.
In America, in America.
This is where they labored, on Santa Clara Street in downtown San Jose, in a grocery store they called the Saigon Mui. I never questioned why my parents didn't translate Saigon Mui. They were Vietnamese. We were Vietnamese. Our language was Vietnamese. By not translating, they proclaimed who they were, where they came from, and their hope that their store would indeed be a new Saigon. Refugees and immigrants become Americans by buying property, putting their language on it, and making everyone see it. My parents were insisting that some part of themselves would not be changed. Their sign in public called out to Vietnamese refugees to build a new community here where we would change the United States as much as it would change us. The Saigon Mui was a gesture of pride, self-determination, and defiance. And for that, my parents paid a price. A robber shot them in their store on Christmas Eve. Two policemen were killed in front of their store. Downtown San Jose was a tough place to do business. The only people who wanted to open businesses here were the Vietnamese. And one day, walking down the street, I saw a sign in another store window. Another American driven out of business by the Vietnamese.
Walked 1,000 miles to this promised land.
This person hated my parents and other Vietnamese people because of who they were. But this person didn't understand that the business of America is to drive other businesses out of business. The Vietnamese brought business to downtown San Jose and the entire city. They made the city better and greater. That's why we need immigrants and refugees. And not just Vietnamese immigrants and refugees, some of whom now fret over the new immigrants and refugees coming here. Once feared some of these Vietnamese, now fear others. And it's sad to see.
Immigrants, we get the job done.
We should embrace new immigrants and refugees. In 30 or 40 years, one of their children will be writing the exact same thing I'm saying now. What was once foreign and strange will be part of American culture. They will be so successful that what they built might be built over. That's what happened to the Saigon Mui. The new city hall was built across the street, and the city forced my parents to sell their property so a symphony could be built there. Instead, the city sold the property to a condo developer for many millions of dollars. My parents never saw that money. This, too, is America. The Saigon Mui was how my parents survived, suffered, and thrived, and became Americans, and raised their sons, and sent money home for many years to many relatives. The Saigon Mui has disappeared from the landscape, but it hasn't disappeared from my memory or my stories.
What a beautiful story, and he told it so well, too. And it's such layered so many ways.
It's such an American story, you know, in so many ways.
And he talks about America, too, warts and all, warts and all, but also the importance of what refugees and immigrants have made in this country. We have to give a shout-out. I don't know if viewers understand how difficult it is to do those pieces where there is no track, just a voice and imagery. So Chris Spinder, Go You producer, Chris Jolly, who edited that, and Chris Gajillion, who oversaw it. I guess you had to be named Chris to work on this piece, but very nicely done, all of you. Very nicely done.
Beautifully done.